Just wanted to make a few comments about the attacks in San Bernardino, California. Well, the attackers are Muslims, and there's no surprise. And they are jihadist, and again, there's really no surprise there either. And they are carrying out the last wishes of Muhammad. And again, there should be absolutely no surprise. I guess the question is, when are people going to wake up and realize that we are at war? But the powers that be, the media, and our elected officials do not want to call it a war. And you have to wonder why. Well, I think, first of all, they're afraid. They're afraid that they are not politically correct, or they would not be politically correct. They're afraid that they'll be called Islamophobes or haters, or worse yet, they may not be re-elected. And that's that is why we're losing this war. And until these attitudes change, these type of attacks are going to continue. We're going to see more and more. And we've seen a lot already. I mean, there's been Fort Hood. It's the one that comes to mind immediately right now. There was Boston. The one in California was seems like it was really well organized. It was a husband and wife team, which is rather frightening. The individual, Farouk, and his wife were well educated, had lots of money, so you can't say they lacked opportunity. You can't blame it on climate change. They were driven by a particular ideology. And the ideology is Islam. Now, one of the solutions, I believe, first of all, before I give you one of the solutions should be, is that Islam is not just a religion. It is rather a political ideology using religious language, and its sole intent is world domination. Islamic ideology is incompatible with Western styled type of democracies. The two will not work together. In fact, I remember seeing one video by a Muslim a couple years ago that says that voting in elections is haram. It is against Islam. Now, I admire the fellow because at least he's being honest. And of course, some people point out to Anjum Chowdhury as being a bit of an extremist. But I think he really reflects what the true view of Islam is. Well, that leads me with only one conclusion, and I must admit I'm a bit troubled, but I believe every Islamic organization needs to be under some type of surveillance. Because, again, I said this is not just a religion like any other religion, which would be guaranteed certain rights under the Constitution. As I mentioned earlier, it is a political ideology bent on overthrowing Western-style democracies. And in a war, you need to watch the enemy. And again, the enemy is Islamic ideology, not necessarily any particularly Muslim. But I think the trend is going to continue. In Canada, we've had an election, and unfortunately, our new Prime Minister is trying to cozy up to Islam. He's trying to probably be Barack Obama light on it. I don't know, he might even be Barack Obama in overdrive over this. But my friends in the United States, you have an opportunity in the next year to make some changes. and hopefully elect people who are aware of what's happening. Of course, then there is always the danger of electing Hillary, Allahu Akbar, Clinton. But folks, I hope I'm wrong. I do hope I'm wrong. But unless people understand exactly what's happening, and again, especially in the political leadership, I think we're going to see more attacks like this. I think they're going to be ongoing. And I guess what is frightening is that, again, this seems to be some type of homegrown Islamic terrorism. So anyways, just some thoughts. I'd like a little bit of feedback. And in closing, just up on the upbeat note, God is sovereign, God is watching over us, and our lives are in His hands, and He's the one that takes care of us. So though the terror may surround me by day and by night, our lives are in the hands of the Lord, and He's the one who keeps us safe. Thanks for watching.